read out. Yes, good morning, students. So today you people will be coming to school for registration purpose. The circular was that on 27th August, all the students from roll number 1 to 47 will reach school in proper uniform. For photograph, timings will be 12:35 to 1:45. Bring rupees 300 for registration fee and rupees 100 for ID card. So total 400 rupees you'll be bringing. Deposit tuition fee along with deposit tuition fee till August, if not deposited. That is very important. It is compulsory to reach the school only on the day and time slot allotted to you for CBSE registration. Is that clear, children? So today be there from 12:35 to 1:45. So of course it will be roll number wise, 1 to 47 roll numbers will be coming. So at 12:35, the first 15 roll numbers reach, then at 12:45, the next 15 reach. So you can come, you can keep yourself in contact with your friends so that there is not much crowd. But yes, don't be late. Don't come after, means come to school by all means by 1 o'clock. Okay, 12:35 to 1 ke beech mein start coming. So first 15 roll numbers should come at 12:35 sharp. Okay. So we were discussing the summer of beautiful white horse for revision purpose today. So here, what is that white horse which the boys Murad and Aaron, these two boys are there in the story, and they belong to, they are actually Armenian boys. These are two Armenian boys who belong to Garagrodian family. These Armenian boys, Aram Murad, they belong to Garagrodian family, and this family is known for truth and honesty. But one thing more this family is known for, what is that? Poverty. They are poor also. They are also known for poverty. So see the contrast, like this family is known for poverty, but despite poverty, they are also very truthful and honest. Because it is often said, like if one is poor, one becomes dishonest by default. But this family was by default truthful and honest, though they were very poor also. Okay, so this is one aspect of their, you know, identity, you can say. Now, what is white horse? It's the one which these two boys have taken from John Byrow. John Byrow is the owner of the horse, white horse. So they have taken, the boys have taken the horse of John Byrow. Literally, if you say, then it was a stealing, because John Byrow did not know who had taken his horse, where his horse was. Literally, it was a stealing, but this family, because cannot steal, because they are known for their truthfulness and honesty. And now, children, we are to prove this in the story. Like, yes, these two boys have not actually stolen. They've not stolen it. They have been able to keep the name of their family as being honest and truthful. How can we do this? How is it possible to say that the boys have not stolen the horse, despite the fact, like, literally they have stolen? But we are not to admit that they have stolen it. Why? The answer is because these two boys, Murad had actually stolen the horse. So he took this man's horse not for selling. His purpose was not to sell the horse. His purpose was only to keep the horse with himself for a few days and enjoy its ride. Because both of these boys were very fond of horse riding. It was their passion, rather. So they had taken this horse for some time, and they were of the idea, like after having enjoyed the horse ride for some days, they would return it. So their intention was not to sell it in the market and to get money out of it. So they say, like, we have not stolen the horse, we have only taken it for some time. So this concept is there in the story, on the basis of which the boys claim that they have not stolen. They have not, belied the trust of their family or the name of their family, which is known for being truthful or honest. Got it? So this is one aspect of the story. And another aspect of the story is Murad himself. So Murad is known in the story as a... So Murad is a person who is like his uncle. Like his uncle Khosrov. So Murad is like his uncle Khosrov as far as his, fanciful ideas are concerned. He is called as the crazy streak. He is called, Murad is considered crazy. And he has inherited the trait of craziness from his uncle Khosrov. Got it? Now the point is, like, how can you say that Uncle Khosrov was crazy? How can you say this? Because Uncle Khosrov was crazy. Because he would not behave normally at all situations. At each time, whenever there would be something, whatever kind of situation it would be, he would always say, yes, there is no harm in it. Okay, there is no harm in it. So he would always say that there is no harm in it. It's not possible that in every situation you say the same thing. There is no harm in it. So the biggest example of his being eccentric was, like, once Uncle Khosrov's house was on fire. His son ran to inform him that the house was on fire. At that time, the uncle was in a barber's shop. So there, that man went in to inform him. And the moment he was informed that their house was on fire, Uncle Khosrov shouted like usual. So what? There is no harm in it. So that was the height of it. Like, he was saying there is no harm in it even when his own house was on fire. So what we call it? Of course, craziness. Or what else? If you call, can you tell, like, what would you call this kind of man as? How can you describe this kind of man, the one who always say, doesn't matter, it's okay. There is no harm in it means in layman, like, it's okay, it doesn't matter. I don't mind it. It means this basically. So what does, how will you describe this man in your words? Basically, if somebody's small thing is lost, one becomes so worried. But he doesn't get worried even when his house is on fire. And this very dialogue will also be heard when John will come to tell him that his horse has been stolen. Even then he will tell him, so what? There is no harm in it. And when John Byrow will go and tell him that he has found his horse, even then he will say, there is no harm in it. Everything is all right. So what? There is no harm in it. So what will you say about this man? Positive. Okay. So you can say that he is the one who is detached. Doesn't mind whatever is happening in life. Because if there is some loss, if something has been done, you cannot undo it. And this kind of philosophy is, adopted by only a few people in life. Okay, basically, no one can bear the loss, personal loss. But he is not only able to manage his personal loss, he is also able to tell others the same thing. For him, getting something or losing something is same. Only this kind of person is able to can maintain the family name for being truthful and honest. The one who doesn't mind loss, for him loss doesn't matter. That's why the family name for being truthful and honest will be maintained. Got it? So now Murad is like him. Murad is no less in being truthful or honest. But he has stolen the horse of John Byrow. What will you say about it? Isn't he a thief? No? Why? Yes, very good. So you cannot call this boy Murad a thief, because the horse which he has taken, that horse he doesn't want to sell. What do the thieves always do? Thieves steal something and they sell the thing and they get money. That is what the thieves always do. But here Murad has taken the horse only for some time. And during this time, he takes a very good care of the horse. And even his uncle Khosrow, and even this John Byrow in the end will say this thing, that his horse has been better tended and groomed. He will take such good care of the horse that the horse will not only be physically more fit, he will also be better groomed. What is grooming? Teaching the manners and etiquettes to the pet. Okay, so he will teach him manners and etiquettes to the horse, and the horse will become better tempered. Okay, it's very easy to get a pet, but more difficult is to groom the pet. Okay, some people, you know, they even hire instructors to train their pets, but some people don't even mind teaching the simple mannerisms to their pets. And those pets don't mind biting anyone on the road. So having a pet or having a domestic animal and training it, that is also very important. And this is what Murad did. If he was enjoying the horse ride, then he was also taking care of the well-being of the horse, not only from the physical point of view, but also from the point of view of his health and grooming. So Murad had taken the horse to take care of him or to enjoy the ride, and he even groomed him well. And one thing more about Murad, we say that he has a crazy streak in him like his uncle. One thing more Murad had, that was that he had a way with, so we can say like he is kind. He's very kind. He has a way with all. He has a way with all means he can tackle everybody. He can tackle animals. He can tackle animals, birds or animals. There is an example of bird also, the one which it was able to groom or tend. Then it Murad has a way with animals like with horse. He has a way with people also. Children minded, it's very easy. People often say like, I can tackle any animal. I can tackle any animal. But the most difficult thing is to tackle people in this life. You can win the world, but you cannot win your own people around you. Okay? So that is also a skill. And this boy also has that skill. He can tackle people. Do you remember some example from the story from which you can say, like what I am saying, that is true? He has a way with people. What's the example? Yes, you're right, Samriddhi or Riddhi. So when he is able to tackle John Byrow, that shows that he has a way to tackle people also. What happens in that incident? Some children might have missed the lecture that day. So John Byrow's horse was taken by Murad, right? But John Byrow did not know that Murad, the horse, was with him. One day, these two boys were riding the horse. John Byrow encounters them, sees them. John Byrow finds that the two boys had a white horse, and he goes near them. He observes the horse very minutely, and then he says, had it not been with you people, then I would have sworn that this is my horse. Tooth by tooth, nail by nail, it seems to be my horse. But because you people are having it, so it can't be mine. Right? So at the time, it was Murad and that boy's confidence that this man was not at all doubtful. One thing is here now. What do you think? Was John Byrow really not able to recognize his horse? Yes. John Byrow said, like, had it not been you people, ki agar ye aapke paas horse nahi hota, then I would have sworn that it is my horse. But because it is with you, I cannot say this is my horse, because you are known for honesty and truthfulness. Means your khandan is not known for truthfulness. Then how can I say that you people have stolen my horse? Now my question is, do you think John Byrow meant it? Did he really mean this? That it was not his horse? Did he really believe in this? What I think is, John Byrow might have been able to recognize that was his horse. This is what he said even. Tooth by tooth, nail by nail, it's my horse. But because it's with you, I cannot claim it. So he refused to claim the horse just because he wanted, he did not want to defame the family, which is known for truthfulness and honesty. So when you've got so much in your credit, then your whole name and fame cannot be debited. It has to be given some benefit. So name and fame matters. Sometimes your good reputation matters. If you always do something nice, and if you've done something wrong sometime, then your good deeds will save you sometime. And it happens. Okay? So always do good, but by chance, by mistake, if something wrong is done, that can be compensated sometimes. Because your good deeds will also be kept in mind by others. That is, what really happens in life. So John Byrow refused to recognize the horse. And what I think, and you must also know this, you can also feel this, like it was an intentional decision. Okay? And finally, when Murad saw that they just got a narrow escape, there and then these boys went in to keep the horse at John Byrow's place, farm. So they kept the horse there. John Byrow got his horse back. Then he again went to Uncle Kostov to inform him that he had got his horse back. Earlier, he had gone to complain him that his horse was stolen. Then he saw the horse with these boys. Then he saw that his horse is back. Then he went to Uncle Kostov to tell him that his horse is there. And then also Uncle Kostov shouted like usual, "So what? There is no harm in it. Come on. Sometimes you get something. Sometimes you do something. Don't bother much." But one thing is here, uncle cause he even tells him that his horse is better tended and better groomed. And actually, here John Biro was praising the boys. At the time, Aram was there at home. And he knew that the horse was with the boys. So without creating any fuss, without creating any issue, the things are settled. Thanks to the name of the family, thanks to the sensible boys, thanks to the sensibility shown by John Biro as well. Right? So this character is equally important in the story. Is that clear? So this is the crux of the chapter. So there are so many things which were not written in the story, but which I have spoken from my side to make you people understand like what the writer wants to convey to us. Okay, so you read the story very carefully. MCQs will be there. And MCQs, you will be able to tackle only when you know the concept. Yes. How? Okay, yes. The summer of beautiful white horse. So white horse, you understand, like here we have, it's the white horse only which is being talked about. The summer of, summer is the season. In India, the way we talk about spring season as the best season, in England or in the Western countries, it's the summer which is described as the most beautiful season in the year. So it's the most beautiful time of the life of maybe the horse when he came into the hands of Murad and Aram. Okay, the summer of beautiful white horse. So what's the beautiful time the horse had when it was with Aram and Murad? So that's it, children. So you can read the chapter carefully on your own. And today you have to come to school also at 12:35. Get ready. Okay. So if you've not deposited the fee, that also you can do. Okay. So see you at 12:35 in the school. Yeah. Any doubt? So I guess the attendance has been taken.